Involuntary manslaughter. Comment below. Let us know what you think regarding the subject matter at hand. Anita Sosa asks, my sister had gambling vices. One day when I went to see her at her house, I found a man choking her. Apparently, she owed him money from a bet. I got a bat and I hit him in the head. The man fell and died. A friend was waiting for him outside, and when he did not come out, he entered the house and found him dead. The police called and I was arrested. I have been accused for defending my sister and preventing her from being strangled. So, here's the deal. You have the legal right to use whatever force necessary to protect your life or the life of somebody else. And that necessary force could include deadly force. If somebody is in the process of killing one of your loved ones and you have no other choice but to kill that other person, it would be legal. So that shouldn't even be an involuntary manslaughter. That should just be, hey, self-defense or defense of others. It should be an affirmative defense, which means the case should be dismissed. However, the reason why there's an arrest, obviously, is because the police have to investigate the matter. They can't be like, oh yeah, well, maybe you murdered somebody, maybe you didn't, so we'll look into it. It's like, no, they're going to arrest you. They're going to study the case. They're going to see, you know, how damaged your sister was. You know, are there indentations of the thumbs going in when the guy was choking her? What's the history? Did he send her threatening messages? All that stuff needs to be looked at to have and based on the totality of circumstances, the DA's office could even choose not to file on the case. Now, if the case actually does get filed on, and if the DA eventually does not dismiss the case, well, then your case should be taken to a jury trial where they will bring in 12 people from the community who would listen to all of the evidence, including all the forensic experts. And then at the end, they will have to determine whether or not you're innocent or guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. Regardless, if you'd like to learn more about criminal defense here in the San Francisco Bay Area, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, Law Offices of Cross and Associates, and feel free to ask questions in the comment section below so that we may respond in the future with more videos for you. But if you've been accused of a crime here in the San Francisco Bay Area and need representation, give us a call for free consultation at 1-800-862-7677. Once again, 1-800-862-7677. On our next video, we're going to be discussing a false kidnapping. All right, have a good day.